Hi there! As you probably don't know, I've been living in this apartment for almost 4 years now. And I have to say that I'm quite happy with the electrical wiring. Not only does it follow pretty much the newest standards, but my landlord also threw in a bonus by using a surge relay for my corridor. In case you do not know, a surge relay is basically an electrical component that turns on or off its internal relay outputs whenever it gets connected to mains voltage on its input sides. In my case, the internal relay is connected to all the LED downlights in my corridor, while the input side is connected to a bunch of push buttons, which I basically only have to push for a brief moment in order to turn on or off my lights. Another awesome feature of those LED downlights is that they dim themselves in 4 steps, whenever they get powered up in rapid succession. But as you might already have noticed, one of those lights died on me after only 1.5 years of usage. Now of course, I could order a replacement, which I actually already did. But for a price of roughly 20 euros, I thought it was time to get to the bottom of this problem and have a closer look at the lights in order to find out why it actually does not work anymore. And be prepared for a surprise, because along the way we will also investigate the same downlight type but with a newer hardware revision. And oh boy, there are a lot of changes. So let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, which is a PCB manufacturer that I've been using for years. And currently they are improving their delivery times. They want to achieve 2-3 days for the USA and 3-5 days for Europe. So why not test out their fast service by uploading your Gerber files today and thus ordering high quality PCBs from them. First off, I obviously pulled the faulty downlight out of the ceiling, opened up its cabling enclosure and freed it from its mains wiring connection. Of course, I turned off all the fuses while doing that. And now is also the time that I have to warn you that we're dealing with mains voltage here, which can cause major injuries if not handled correctly. You have been warned. But anyway, as soon as I got the light on my workbench, I firstly had a closer look at its outer appearance. And I have to say that its quality did not seem half bad. So, after removing the protective sleeve, which covered the mains voltage wires, I hooked them up to a mains power connector with Vago clamp terminals in order to confirm that the downlight truly does not function. But to my own surprise, the light lit up without any problems, and was also able to dim itself after continuously powering it on and off. Now at this point I was very confused, because I actually removed this downlight from the ceiling and reinstalled it there 3 times already, and it never worked so far. The first culprit that came to my mind though was that it was easily possible to bend the mains voltage wires 90 degrees at the point where they enter the light's body. In the worst case, this could lead to a cable break, with the inner copper wire being partly or completely broken. And guess what, after I finished my more in-depth electrical investigation on the lights, which I will tell you about in a second, I actually checked for a cable break, and as it turns out, that was the main culprit. And the manufacturer apparently knew about this problem as well, because after I unpacked my ordered replacement downlights, it turns out that they added a mechanical construction in order to prevent such cable breaks. Brilliant! While having a look at this improved version of my LED downlight, I also started to wonder what else they changed, and thus I quickly hooked up the new light to mains voltage in order to find out that they even changed the dimming feature. It still dims itself in 4 steps, but did you notice that this time there's no flickering? If we compare it to the old lights, we can clearly see the difference. And that was the moment to dig deeper. And thus, I started with the old downlight by unscrewing it from its metal body. Next, I pulled the main body out of the plastic housing and continued by removing the light diffuser with the help of a screwdriver, which I then also used to lift out the PCB with the LEDs and later also the PCB with the main electronics on it. And after I was done removing all of the thermal compound, it was finally time to look at the PCB and its electrical circuits in order to find out how it works. The first thing I noticed though was that the hand-soldered connections didn't look very reassuring. But before I start to nitpick all day about other minor problems, I instead started following the traces of the circuits with the help of my multimeter in order to come up with this reverse engineered schematic. To understand how it works, you might be asking yourself what the job of the ICs is. And I would have to say that I do not have a definitive answer, because one of them is not labeled, while for the other one you can find no information about it on the internet. So I was forced to hook up all of my test equipment in order to find out how the circuit works. The first thing I noticed was that even while the LEDs were turned on for quite some time, and thus obviously got hotter, the flowing current through them did only barely change. In fact, the voltage across them even decreased, which means that we're dealing with a constant current driver here, which is definitely the right way to drive LEDs. But if you have no idea what I'm talking about, then make sure to watch my video about how to drive LEDs properly. Anyway, in order to dim the brightness of the LEDs, the second IC comes into play, which basically only lets this constant current flow with a certain duty cycle, which decreases while going through the four dimming steps. That is why we get this ugly flickering on camera, because the LEDs actually turn on and off rapidly with a frequency of around 280 Hz. Last but not least, we also got an RC timer circuit to let the system know if we want to go to the next dimming step or restart with max brightness. And that's it in a nutshell, which is not a bad concept, but it can be executed way better. And we can find out how by opening up the newer downlight of the exact same type. First off, the main PCB is this time secured in place with screws instead of glue, which is awesome. Next, they got rid of the wired connection to the LED PCB, and instead used such a header construction, which is way more reliable. Also, the amount of used components on the PCB has decreased tremendously, which means there are less sources for faults. And needless to say, reverse engineering the schematic for the circuit was this time also way faster and easier to do. But on the negative side, information about this new IC can still not be found on the internet. But it seems like the system still uses a constant current driving method. This time though, in order to dim the brightness, the constant current value and thus the applied voltage to the LEDs gets decreased instead of pulsing the LEDs. Now you might be thinking that this method would be more inefficient, since more voltage would have to drop over the main electronics instead of the LEDs, which would equal more power losses and thus heat. But as you can see, the temperature of the new downlight PCB only reached around 50 degrees Celsius after 5 minutes, while the old light reached a temperature of 53 degrees Celsius after the same time. The reason is the new LED PCB design, which uses less LEDs, but each one requires a higher voltage than the old LEDs. This way, the combined voltage drop of the new LEDs is quite a bit higher than the old design, and thus it weighs less power, even if we decrease the voltage down to the darkest dimming level. Of course, I also calculated the efficiency of all the dimming steps, just to be on the safe side, which proves my point. So, all in all, it is kind of crazy how a new hardware revision of the same product can change so much. The new downlight comes with a better mechanical construction, features less components, does not come with camera flickering, and has a higher efficiency and thus produces less heat. Needless to say, I will happily be using this new version in case more of my old downlights decide to quit working. And I hope that you enjoyed this video, and maybe even learned something new along the way. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!